Alright, so today we are going to learn how to reset passwords on Windows 10 computers. And the method we are going to use will allow you to change the existing password to any password of your choosing. And you'll be able to log into the machine and do what needs to be done. We don't learn this for the sake of breaking into people's computers illegally. Because once someone has a password on their computer, it means they want to protect their privacy. If you break into their computer without permission, it is against the law, and any law anywhere will take you on. So, we don't break into people's rooms without permission, it is illegal. So, if someone has a password on their computer, it is illegal to break into it without permission. As technicians, you need to have these skills because there will be several situations where computers will come to you that you would have to get access into, but there is no way of getting access to the password, or the owners have forgotten the passwords and you are told to help them regain access to their computers. Or machines that you would have to get access to where they fall under your jurisdictions, or they fall under your rights and your power to get access to them, you should be able to get access to them. Sometimes a computer can come to you and you are supposed to work on it. There's no way of getting access to the password. The machine has been brought to you to access and work on it. So as a technician, when something like this is brought to you, you are given the power to work on the machine. But in this case, you don't have access to log into the machine, and you don't want to format the hard drive. Because if you don't have the password and you can't get into the Windows, to repair the machine, it means you need to format it. Unless, of course, you can take the hard drive into a different machine to check the content or to back up the data. But if password is the only thing hindering you from backing up data or protecting data, then you should be able to have the skills to log into it. All right, so with Windows 10, you need to have a USB drive. And this USB drive contains the Windows 10 setup. The Windows 10 setup. I believe you know what the Windows 10 setup is. The normal Windows 10 installation setup. So you make it bootable onto a USB drive. And this is what we do whenever we are installing Windows 10 on any computer. We make a USB drive bootable. So I believe you know how to do this already. If not, I'll make a video on how to make a bootable disk. You can also use CD or DVD. So we can continue to step two. Step two is to make sure the machine is off completely. So let me shut down this machine. All right, so the machine is completely off now. What we have to do now is to connect the USB drive. So you connect the USB drive to the computer as though you want to run a new Windows 10 installation. So once that is connected, you on the computer and you make sure you boot from the USB. To boot from the USB, you can press F12 or any key that will show the boot options. All right, so we boot to our boot menu. All right, so you press a key that will show your boot menu, and then you move to USB. So I have seen USB now because I've connected to the right port. So you hit enter and Windows 10 will start as though you are about to do the installation. And so you wait for it to get to the first welcome screen where the installation needs to start, where you click next. That is where you start the process from. This is a state where you have to normally continue to install your Windows, right? All right, so when you get here, what you do is to press Shift F10. So the first thing to do is to press Shift F10 to launch the command prompt. Once you launch command prompt, you need to run diskpath. So you let this part run, and when this part runs, my this part is loading now. Okay, this part is ready for commands. All right, so now that this part is ready, you need to list volume. When you list volume, it will list all the available volumes on your machine. I believe we've done this, right? Good. Now you need to select the volume that has your operating system. So when I check volume 0, I think it's a volume 0 is DVD, right? Volume 1 is a 500 meg partition. That's not what has the operating system. So I think my operating system is from volume what? 2. Volume 2 drive E, right? 232 gig. That's where my operating system is. And I will exit DexPath. So this exit is not exiting command prompt. It is exiting DexPath. Let me type CLS to clear my screen to get a fresh screen to work in. So CLS to get a fresh screen to work. And now that I have CLS, I need to log into the drive E. So I'll go to drive E column. I'm in drive E. I need to browse to where I have my Windows operating system. So I'll type CD Windows, and then I'll type CD System 32. That is where the file I am targeting is. And that file is called utilman.exe. So I'm going to create a copy of the file so that I don't destroy it. So I will just say copy utilman.exe to utilman1.exe. So what I'm doing is that I'm creating a copy of utilman because I'm going to tamper with utilman. So I want to create a copy so that I don't destroy it. Is that okay? So enter, one file has been copied. So now we have two utilmans. Then I want to do same to command prompt because I'm going to tamper with command prompt too. So I'll say copy cmd.exe to cmd1.exe. This simply means copy and paste here, or create a copy and rename it as this. So the second copy is going to be cmd1.exe. So when I do this, I have created a copy of cmd and I also have a copy of utilman. Now I can delete utilman. So del utilman.exe. I want utilman to go away. So if you don't see anything, it means it has worked. So utilman, the original utilman is gone. Now what I want to do is to rename my cmd.exe as utilman.exe. I'm renaming cmd.exe to what? Utilman. So once I do this, it has worked. So my CMD has been renamed to utilman. I following. Good. So now I'm done. I will just exit this and restart my computer. Then we'll get to the last stage. So I'll just restart. I'll remove the drive now. I don't need the disk anymore. I needed the disk to access command prompt from here. So now that I've accessed command prompt, I've done the operation I need to do. I just wait for the machine to boot. Right. So immediately you restart your computer, you'll be brought to this screen. This is a screen you usually use to log on to your computer. But since we don't know the password, we have to click something here I want to show you. Come to the Ease of Access Center. So you bring your pointer to this area called Ease of Access. So click on Ease of Access and you will have command prompt open. So once command prompt is open like this, all you need to do is to enter the command that will take you in. So the command I need to use is just one command. All you need to do is to remember just one command. If you can remember that command, you have access to change the password. So this is a command, control user passwords 2. Control user passwords 2. Control user passwords 2. Once you enter this command, just hit enter. and you get access to the user accounts window. Over here, you want to select the account that you want to change its password. So I select this account and I click on reset password. You click on reset password. Immediately you click on reset password, you have the chance to enter a new password. So go ahead and put in any password you want. For example, I want to give the user a new password, 1111. Come here and confirm your password. Confirm new password, 1111. And click OK. Immediately you click OK, the password has been changed. Come and click OK again. Close your command prompt. And now you are ready to log in with a new password. So go to the logon screen, select the account, and enter the password. The password we just set is 1111. Hit enter, and voila, you are in. So we've been able to log into the computer without having a password. This can be done to any Windows 10 computer. All you need is a Windows 10 bootable USB or CD, and you'll be able to do this. All right, so now we have access into the computer. We've been able to log on into a computer without a password. Now, because of the changes we made, for some of you, your CMD will no longer be working. So we want to reverse the changes. So to do that, we will be shutting down the machine. We will connect our Windows 10 bootable USB again, and we will log on to the command line interface and reverse the files we renamed so that everything will work well. To be sure if your CMD is working or not, press Windows R to launch your run and type CMD. If CMD doesn't work, it means command prompt is not working because of the changes we made. So we want to reverse it so that command prompt will work again. So now let's shut down the computer completely and reverse the changes. So you go to shutdown and shut down the computer. Now that the computer is off, you want to connect your Windows 10 bootable USB into the computer, and you on the computer, boot onto the Windows setup on the USB. So you on the computer, press F12 or any key that will load your boot options. So I'm pressing F12. Now I have my boot menu here and I can select USB. So I scroll down to USB, I click on it, and I have my USB. So I'm booting onto the Windows setup on USB. When that happens, I'll be able to reverse the changes we made. All right, so this is a screen we are waiting for. Now you want to press Shift and F10. Remember, Shift, hold the Shift key and press F10. So now we have Shift F10. At least we have this running from the USB, so it will always work. This is not a CMD on your main operating system. This is CMD booting from the Windows 10 bootable. Now we want to log on to the main partition of our operating system, and we have learned that it is drive E. If you don't remember, you need to go through the dixpath process again and identify the drive. But now that we know it's drive E, let's just try logging on to drive E. So type E colon and enter, and we are in. So let's just browse to CD Windows, enter. Then we'll enter CD System 32, enter. We are in System 32. So now let's reverse the process what we did before. So to reverse everything we did, we will rename. Let's rename cmd1.exe to cmd.exe. And this will solve our CMD problems. Now, to solve the utilman problem, what we have to do is to delete the existing utilman and rename the older utilman. So we type del utilman.exe, then we hit enter, and utilman is gone. So we can rename utilman1.exe to utilman.exe. Now that this has worked, we have everything we need. So we have been able to reverse the entire process. Now all we have to do is to shut down and restart our computer. Okay, so our Windows is ready. Let me just log on with the password we reset, 1111, enter. Okay, so it looks like everything is okay. We've been able to log on to Windows 10. Now all we have to do is to test whether our CMD is working. If CMD works, then our job is done. So let's test by pressing Windows R, and we will type CMD and hit enter. If CMD opens, wow, so this is CMD for you. It has opened, and so we have been able to reverse all the changes we made, and we've been able to achieve the password reset. We've been able to reverse the file changes we made, and everything is perfectly okay now. Alright, so if you want to learn more from me, make sure you subscribe to this channel, like this video, comment. If you have a question, put a question in the comment box and I'll be sure to answer you. Share this video with your friends and make sure you follow me for more tutorials. Thank you once again, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye.